Welcome to another Ayehu iShare tutorial. Today, we'll see how easy it is to integrate iShare with ServiceNow. Ayehu iShare IT process automation, integrated with ServiceNow, provides workflows and runbooks that extend ServiceNow ITSM capabilities. Instead of manual, repetitive tasks and service desk procedures, you can now create a closed-loop automated process that accelerates your incident management process. In today's example, we'll see how iShare receives a request to create a new virtual machine from ServiceNow and initiates a workflow that handles this request. Let's see how it works. Open iShare Studio, and under Configuration, Modules, let's define new module, ServiceNow. Enter the module name, description, and select the device on which the module is installed. Usually, it'll be localhost. Press Configure to define module settings. Enter the URL for ServiceNow and the username and password. Hit the Test Connection button to establish the connection with your ServiceNow. Next, press the Forms button to import ServiceNow forms and define their filters and mapping settings. Hit Load Defaults to import ServiceNow default forms. Now, hit the Mapping button to map the ServiceNow properties to iShare variables. This screen basically replaces the tag mechanism when it comes to incoming ServiceNow requests. Using it, you can define what value will be assigned to the incident variables without having to create a new tag. Use the Severity Mapping tab in order to translate ServiceNow's severities into iShare severities. Note that you can assign a static severity or a customized severity, depending on the relevant field in the form. Use the State Mapping tab to translate ServiceNow states into iShare states. Note that, once again, you can assign a static state or a customized state, depending on the relevant field in the form. Finally, hit Update to update filters and settings. And now, save the module and make sure it's up. In order to initiate a workflow triggered by an oncoming request, you need to create a new action rule in Studio Action Rules. Each rule is based on a condition and a workflow that should be executed when the condition is matched. Our condition is based on two elements, the ServiceNow form name and the configuration item type. As soon as iShare receives a change request from ServiceNow and the configuration is virtual machine, we'll execute the workflow. Here's the workflow that'll be executed when the condition is matched. We'll review it a little bit later on. Now, let's see the process in action. Let's create a new request in ServiceNow. Enter the requester name, select category, enter the required VM name, the CPU number, the required disk space in megabytes, and the required memory size in megabytes. Select the configuration item, and enter the short description. Now let's hit Submit. Now let's head over to the iShare dashboard where we can view events and requests that are currently open. See that? The new request appears in the iShare dashboard. iShare initiates the workflow that handles the new request and creates a new virtual machine. First, it sends the request details to the system administrator to approve this request. You'll notice that the iShare bidirectional communication channels mean that you can easily create interactive workflows. Here's the email including the request details, and the administrator can approve the request by replying yes. iShare identifies his answer and creates the new virtual machine according to the request details. In addition, it updates ServiceNow and closes that request. Finally, it sends a confirmation email to the requester. And here's that email. Now let's switch back to ServiceNow in order to view the closed request. As you can see, it's closed right over there as complete. Okay, now finally let's review the workflow that we used for this demo. Here's our deploy new VM upon ServiceNow request procedure. And here's the ServiceNow action set. We use it to create, get, and update records in ServiceNow. Our workflow starts with sending the request details to the sysadmin for approval. You can see that the request details are actually the ServiceNow request fields. If the administrator replies yes, eyeShare creates the new virtual machine using the VM create action. Notice how we use the request fields as parameters inside that action. After creating the new VM, eyeShare updates the request using the ServiceNow update request action. Finally, it sends a confirmation email to the requester. This concludes our ServiceNow integration demo. For more information, please visit our website at www.ayehu.com.